Seize life, eat bread with gusto, drink wine with a robust heart. Oh yes, God takes pleasure in your pleasure. Dress festively every morning. Don't skimp on colors and scarves. Relish life with the spousey love each and every day of your precarious life. Each day is God's gift. It's all you get in exchange for the hard work of staying alive. Make the most of each one. Whatever turns up, grab it and do it, and heartily.
Thank you. And now Paula and Daniel are going to come and perform My Love Is Like a Red, Red Rose.
Yeah, it's on.
See, life is good. We're going to light the unity candles now, which, as I say, Lorna and Shelley had lit at the beginning of the service. And we're going to light it as a representation of two families coming together, as well as two individuals coming together. So Kate and Earl, I'll invite you to come. Kate, this is the one that your mum lit, and this is the one that your mum lit, Lorna. Yeah. As we light this candle, let it represent the unity of Earl and Kate from this moment on. As this one light cannot be divided, neither shall their marriage or lives be divided. May the radiance of this one light be a testimony of your unity. The lighting of this unity candle symbolizes the joining together of two families and the union of two individuals becoming one in commitment. Come stand in the front again. Kate and Earl, this is a big day for you. It's a big day for all of us. It's a big day for your families and your friends. And from going forward, I hope you have lots of big days, lots of exciting days, lots of days which are very special. You'll also have lots of days which are very ordinary. You'll have lots of days which began as this morning did, with the rain thundering down. You've noticed that we've managed to dry it up for you arriving, Kate. You'll have days when you've nothing much to do and you're kicking your heels about, and you might even find time to argue with each other, because that's what happens in marriage, that people argue with each other. But I hope you'll find something special in all the days that you share, something which you can rejoice over and laugh about, something which just says to you, aren't we lucky that we're together and that we're one and that we're going to be like this for the rest of our lives. It said in the readings from Colossians that you were called. Now that's a very special thing. It's not just that you chose one another, although you did choose one another, but you were also called to be with one another. And there's an exclusivity about that that says you two are special to each other. You're special to an awful lot of people here as well. But there's something about that that says you were called and that that's a purpose and that's something that you two must fulfill. But almost immediately, Colossians says that you should live that exclusive calling in very practical and very generous ways, that you should live with compassion and joy and love and forgiveness. And that means that you should show that to each other, but it means that you should show it to other people as well. That when people look at the two of you and the laughter that you share and the love that you share and the joy that you share, that they will recognize something of God in the two of you. Carry on enjoying life, carry on enjoying each other's company. You don't live traditional lives. You're going to be all over the place in the next wee while, getting jobs, being on tour, being in pantomime, all these things. That was the opportunity for somebody to shout, "Oh no, you wouldn't." You're not going to be Mr. and Mrs. Normal living in a semi-detached somewhere. You're always going to live that slightly eclectic life of people who are performers. And so you need to find something very strong to bind you together in the times when you're not together. I have no worry thinking that you're going to find that. And that's your joy, your love, your faith, your commitment, your graciousness and your forgiveness. Enjoy this day. Enjoy the day when we get together and we sign the official bit of paper. Yes, yeah. We'll try and make that special too, but perhaps not such a big event.
Okay.
Enjoy the days when the rain is falling and when the bills are coming in and when the rubbish needs to be put out and when you're not really very sure what to do. Enjoy those days as well. And do that with our blessing and our love and our support, with God's love and God's blessing and God's support, but more importantly, with the love and the joy that you both share. Enjoy today, enjoy the rest of your lives together. Let us pray. And before we pray, in Scotland, when we say the Lord's Prayer, we have this strange habit of saying debts rather than trespasses. If you think that's too much to take in, say during the prayer whatever suits you. And those of us who say debts will leave a wee bit more time for those who say trespasses to catch us up. But let us pray. Gracious God, for the promise, for the hope, for the love of this day, we praise you. Bless your children, Kate and Earl, with the strength of your spirit, that they may build a life of joy and fulfillment on the foundations of commitment and love. May they be sustained by the love and support that now surrounds them. May they always remain open-hearted, courageous and strong. Give to them generosity of spirit, understanding of each other, warm and loyal friendship. Grant that they may go forward from this day delighting in their love. May their love grow, and in time to come may it prove able to heal and to help, to overcome difficulties and to bring reconciliation. So may all see in Kate and Earl a symbol of your love, from which nothing can separate us and which nothing can overcome. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, and we pray together in the words he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen. In just a couple of moments, we're going to sing our final hymn on your order of service, which is Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. And then Kate and Earl and their supporters and their family are going to be leaving by the door that many of you came in. If you would like to see them going out and meeting them outside, the door at the back is also open, and you're welcome to sneak out there and give them a big cheer as they come out of the main door. So can I invite you to stand as we sing together our second hymn, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise.
Oh, my.
And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest with you and remain with you, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Will you please remain standing?
These arms are I need your tenderness.